Kenzie, welcome back. How did the time in Utica go?
Good, yeah, it was good for me. Great group there. Coaches and the players are awesome, you know, really welcoming. And, you know, I got a lot of reps down there, got my own net for a couple days, got some games. Definitely helped, you know, get me back.
And now that you're back here with practice, how did it feel getting your first reps back with the main team?
It's great. You know, I'm happy to be back. You know, excited to get back into some games up here and, you know, just keep building.
As you're watching this team, what can you really bring with energy or a boost as they're going through this skid and you're finally coming back?
Yeah, you know, we're a good team here. We got great players. You know, sometimes when you get into a little bit of skid, you know, you start, you know, gripping your stick a little tight or you know, trying to force plays to make something happen. And, you know, it makes it almost worse on yourself a little bit. So, you know, I think I'm a pretty calm guy, you know, happy-go-lucky, you know, bring good energy around the guys. So hopefully I can, you know, play well when I get in there and, you know, just try to, you know, steady the ship and keep the boys rolling.
Mackenzie, I know this has probably been a moment that you've been thinking about and, you know, drooling about the past couple of weeks, but, you know, just for it to finally be here, how does that feel?
It's good. I'm drooling. yeah, no, it's great. I mean, obviously, not ideal what happened. Obviously, it's kind of a broken record at this point with, you know, certain unfortunate bounces that happened to myself over the last year or so. But, you know, I'm just happy to, you know, be healthy again, practicing with the team and ready to start playing some games again.
And what did it look like over the past couple of weeks to watch Akira and VTech do so well and, you know, just for you not to be able to, you know, get in there and
yeah. You know, it's just the way it goes sometimes. You know, you're going to get on hot streaks, guys are going to play well. It's part of the job. You just got to stay level. You know, you're happy for them. They're playing well. You know, I'm happy that they're doing great. I see the work they put in. So, you know, as a teammate, you're happy for that. And, you know, just trying to get myself ready to go so that, you know, when I'm back in the net, I can just try and continue where we left off.
You always say to be a very positive guy, and you've gone through some adversities. Does that sort of maybe help right now with the team having this little bit of a slide?
Yeah, I mean, I've always tried to keep it real with, you know, myself. You know, if you ride the highs, ride the lows, you know, you're going to drive yourself nuts in this league. You know, it's all about just staying positive and being level and rolling with the punches. You know, when it's going great, don't get too high on yourself. When it's bad, like it has been for myself, you know, don't get too low, stay confident. And, you know, it's just all about, you know, taking it day to day.
As you guys head on to this road trip, two difficult teams, what do you really want to achieve in these next two games?
Well, first we got to think about Carolina first. you know, we need to snap this five-game streak that we're on. You know, we need to bounce back with a win. And tomorrow will be a great test. They're a great team. They're right behind us. So it should be good.
How did you feel practice went today, and what did you all focus on?
Just compete on the puck. You know, that was a big thing that the coaching staff talked about, and that's what we did.
Woody, just to go back to Saturday a little bit, we know what happened with Nico. Were you expecting there should have been a response, or just what was going on there on the bench when he obviously was there?
I think as players, we had no idea what transpired during the game. Remember, we were skating around the second, or right before the second period started, and all of a sudden, there was a scrum in front or in the dot there, and I'm like, I think guys were just more confused. Even Keisher had no idea what happened because it was a quick draw, and then the play was done, and then we went to the room. We had no idea that Barkov was down, so it was just a lot of confusion. And you know, it should have there been a response? I think, you know, internally there was. You know, it wasn't shown on the ice, but guys stepped up, said some stuff to the other team, and but you guys can't see that, but there was verbal talks out there for sure.
So it's no longer old school. I understand that it's not going to be everybody drops the gloves and go, but could there have been more than something said? Could there have been something physically bumping somebody harder? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I mean, you can. I mean, should we have bumped a little more? Yeah, I mean, I think we had 10 or so hits. You know, as a player, if you don't come away with a hit in a game, like, what were you doing type thing? You know, and I've been at fault a few times this year for not stepping in and hitting people and stuff like that, and I've been called out. So it's part of my game, and I think as a whole team, we got to step up more in that department.
McKenzie back in practice today. How good was it to see him after that conditioning stint and coming back since his injury in early November?
Yeah, it's great to see him back. You know, he didn't play a lot last year, and to see him get hurt again early in the year was not ideal, but it's good to see him back playing with us and healthy.
It's all you can really control, just how you work, so it's what I've been doing.
How did you feel to get in the game the other day, and you know, how did you feel at the NHL level?
Oh, it felt good. I thought, like, you know, it's obviously a tough game in the lineup, but even last game, you know, tough game. It's the best team in the league last year. You know, it's going to be a battle. I felt like, you know, as the game went on, I got more physical. I thought I was really pinning guys against the boards. My box outs were, you know, getting better, and that's the kind of thing I'm trying to focus on right now. Just the timing of that, obviously tough for me in my like situation, but you know, it is what it is. I thought that I was getting better progressively throughout the game, and I just got to stick to working on those little details.
I know this is another thing we talked about, but just the balance between being in Utica versus being in the NHL. You know, what's your comfort level there? Would you prefer to be in the NHL or down on the farm?
I mean, everybody wants to be in the NHL, so you know, my goal is to be here, and my goal is every day to come and work and get better every single day.
No one wants to be losing right now, but how are the veterans in this group really rallying to help lift up everyone on this five-game skid?
You know, they're just focusing on getting everybody focused on, like, the details, right? And there's little details in our game that aren't there right now. And, you know, every game's been real close. It's been a one-goal game and then a bunch of empty nets or whatever. But we've been in there every game, and just there's little details we got to work on to, you know, win those games, those one-goal games.
And how encouraging is it to see that they are just really one-goal games at the end of the day?
I mean, it's really encouraging. I thought we had a great start to the season, and then, you know, right now it's a tough stretch. Every team goes through that, but the fact that we're sticking in there and we're still, you know, battling, it's only one goal games. You know, the little details, as long as we focus on those, you know, it's going to get better. We're going to start getting some wins.
You need to have McKenzie back. How did he do in Utica, and how encouraging is it to see him back up here with the Devils?
Yeah, you know, I think reports are I got some rust off in the first game and played really well in the second game, and you know, it's great to get him a couple games and get him back here. We'll get him playing.
Is there an expectation that he will come on the road trip and potentially play?
Yes, definitely. Kira will be going down later today, so it'll be V and Blackie going with us.
And just what did you all focus on in practice today? I know that you're trying to get some little details ironed out with this team.
You know what? You know, again, we worked hard on that down low compete and, you know, creating opportunities off of that. Talked a lot about, you know, that communication with 2D going back. You know, we gave up two goals off of our possession, one with the goalie interchange. So worked on that area of the game, and all likelihood tomorrow have a game to skate and work, get back on special teams.
Lindy, it's not the old days. I understand that the world has changed a little bit. You've played that era. You've coached now through this era. What is a response when the physical side, the fighting is down? What is a proper response when something that happened on Saturday takes place?
Yeah, you know, I think, you know, we were so emotionally engaged in that Philly game, you know, where, you know, they were hard and they were heavy. And I thought, you know, we answered the bell just being physical back. I thought we had times to, you know, to finish checks, to get into people, you know, make it really hard on them. Send a message right back, and you know, I didn't think we were, and I said it after the game, I didn't think we were heavy enough in that category.
Lindy, what sort of went into the Akira decision to send him down? Was it just, you know, wanted to see Blackwood, you know, get another shot?
Blackie has cleared to play. We sent him for conditioning. He's played a couple games. We've thought from day one he's going to be, you know, a big part of our success, and he's back. He's healthy.
Good fans maybe see Akira come up.
What's that?
Never mind.
What did you really see out of Akira's development in this stint up here with the Devils?
I mean, really, you know, for a guy that we didn't know a lot about at the NHL level and maybe struggled last year when we played him, He showed real well. He, you know, he helped get the victories that that we won. I mean, he made key saves. He stepped in the game late in Ottawa and played really well. So, I mean, a great step for him. You know, he should just use that as a springboard. Go down and continue to play the way he's played.